producing the reigning women's team champions. China hold on to their title. Azerbaijan won this title last year. Will they do it again? Mamadov starts out. So first round. Individual, match for match, like for like. 1 minute each. Front leg play. It's fast, but not much scoring opportunities like this. Realistically, the team objective here is to keep it as close as possible for preparation going into round two and three. Just give all the team athletes an opportunity to get some mat time, because we've seen in the first semi-final it was very much the Azerbaijan was very much a two-man team of Archigani and Izayev. So Korea could really do with getting some points on the board in this first round. If they don't, they're going to come up against that combination of Milad Hajigani and Radich Izayev, and they're going to struggle. They're giving away height and range. Legs there. Waziri athlete cleanly. Goes up for big attempt right after on the buzzer. Korea versus one from Korean blue. Korea blue top, white trousers. Blue trim protector and head guard. Azerbaijan standard uniform, white uniform with red trim protector and red head guard. Azerbaijan clearly happy to keep the score close in this first round for 5 minutes. Korean athletes seem quite subdued as well. They don't seem to share my view that they need to get some points on the board. Let's see what happens in the second and third round. Hachigani's on here against Kim. Hachigani in red. Referee with not much to do in this first round. That's a guy just playing off the front leg. So just that front leg to body. In a standard match, it only takes three rounds, and most of the action happens at the end of the third round. So here, in just 1 minute, they're just settling down, and then they go off. So if you play like you're doing a standard match, then there's not going to be much action, and we've seen that in both finals. But I think we've got something to come later on in the second and third round. That's 30 seconds to come into of the first round. Rizev moving forward, but not convincingly. The Korean with a big high disadvantage, and that's going to tell. That will really tell that reach. Gofag, Hachigani, and Izziev will have longer range kicks from the Korean heavyweight, and that will definitely play against him. The mighty Koreans will definitely go to that. Azerbaijan takes 1 point. That's in their first round, only 1 point scored. Korea really don't look like they're going to have any sort of answer to Hachigani and Izziev. Start of the second round. Korea start with their heavyweight. No surprises there. It was just a case of which one Azerbaijan went with, Izayev or Hachigani. And we go for Hachigani. Still taller than the heavy Korean. About 9 kilos difference in them. Looking at the head and tries to back to jump reverse counters as well. So Hachigani be foolish to underestimate this Korean heavyweight. But realistically, we'll see Azayev coming on shortly, I would imagine. Headshot attempt. Hachigani just looked at the scoreboard to see if it had gone on. It was probably a kick to the face. Korea making the change first, which is a little bit of a surprise. But that wasn't a surprise. Azerbaijan bring on Izayev. And two scores, headshot, no points. No points, even another headshot, no points. A little bit of holding down and kicking the head. Gets a warning for holding, but looking to get away with anything more. Here tries for a big punch. Azayev just brushes him aside. No can go for falling because he was after Kallio. I thought the missing points on there. The team scoring the punch. Could just recognising that as a scoring technique. Punching worked very, very well for the Koreans in the semi-final. If he can get inside Izayev and Hachigani's leg length, he might do it. Change of player now. To the army. Kyogan's going to be up most of the time for Korea, I would imagine, against a combination of Radic Izayev and Milad Begi Hachigani. Local crowd going behind the Azerbaijan team. Kill Gannon looking for a headshot there, but pulls it back. Is that Cousin King who did so well? In close range, he's not actually holding, so it's not a foul. Crew make a change. There's a change, and again, Isaiah comes on. Looking for an apple, raising the right hand, that's to stop the present keep coming over the top. Then we've got the Kinkers. Chris Kidd there, very nice. Chris Kidd down comes up. Now that's something, that's great to see from the Korean. He's stepping up the aggression and movement. He's going to need to do a lot more though to get to the head of Rally Gizayev. Gizayev there even closing down before the punch can be thrown. Changed by Azerbaijan. Giving him the break. So Brown is on. So Guliev, actually. Saeed Guliev. Okay, should be trying to get some points here. Climbing and tries to kick, but it's rewarded with a combo every time. First semi-final against Turkey, so clear that out of this game yet. Both find the present kicks in close from the clinches. It's a legal technique as long as they're not holding on to each other. Which end of this second round. First dance up, pushes his opponent over, and gets a warning for it. He's not happy about it, but he's not really any doubt about that. I think we saw there, he's thinking he's scored more headshots, telling his coach. Round for this men's team event. Conrad Jenkins, referee from Jamaica. Quick change over. Does he have sweat for Echigani? Izayev comes on for Echigani against Ingrid in Kyodan. He's his only real answer to the devastating combination of Izayev and Echigani. McCree doing well to limit the score. There's only 8 points difference between them. The Korean team's actually stood in front of me. You can see that they're all quite keen to get in there. When the change is made, they're pushing forwards. So for a round. It really is a kicking machine to the head now. So the clear coach is going to go through all of his teams to try and find somebody that can break through and get some points on the board. Perfect timing. Well, just calling, just a bit of calm between the surrounding. There's an appeal for a face kick there, but the judges disagreed. Not that you can appeal, but once he's dropped in front of the headshot. Winning against Azerbaijan, just for the second point, 10 points difference. Around the corner, Azerbaijan goes up for a headshot. Jesse Kelly for moving out of the contest area. Isaiah comes on. Straight away, Kyodong comes back in. He's not scoring against either of these two players, but at least he's negating some of their aggressive size advantage. That's really aggressive play by Isaiah. Not scoring, his hands are high, he's quite grabby and holding on. That's a move and low kick to top of the leg. Conrad Jenkins pushes him with the Kyongo. Clean coach gives him a chance to recover. I don't think he got much of a chance before we see him come back in. And again, Coach Gary, the match in the close and closing kick. This point gap is starting to increase now. The smaller, shorter Korean team just not taking good defense by Isaiah from stopping the punch from coming through. The Koreans used that so well in the semi-final. To no avail here. Koreans just no answer to the size of Isaiah. Attempt at a reverse turning kick. Chris comes and falls, this is good. He won the only with the turn goal. Nice side kick attempt. Third young from Georgian. Quick kick to the body. He's got the skills, he's got the movements, but it's again Ocho Grande that's getting the points. On the way out. Those are bringing the lighter players in and raising another boost. He's comfortable at this stage, so he's happy to bring him in. Players are getting frustrated. That's about it. As a Yazir supporter behind him, really getting behind their team. You know, there's going to be a victory here. It's very much now watch the margin. All the Yazir athletes looking very, very confident. Throwing kicks at will. We have got to get points at this stage. We've got to be scoring against the lighter players. But they're running out of steam. Tries to reverse to the kick, gets a Kyongo for spinning over again. One minute, 20 seconds. Brazilian athlete happy just to play the count again. A 16-point lead. He doesn't need to be chasing. Career changes, he wants to stay in, but he's not given the opportunity. from North Congo. He wants Molodov wants to stay in. No, Antigani comes in. Waziri players want to stay in. It's not their choice, it's the coach's choice, which tactically is the right thing for this Azerbaijan team. The Koreans have no answer to Hajigani or Izayev. Inkyodom plays a penciling game. That's a right attempt by Kim, but well short to the mark. Hajigani picks him up from the way and gets a pleasant kick as a pinch. Come on, Jenkins catches it. I say more in a pinch. Nice attempt to reverse. But Kuman naked. 30 seconds on. Yeah, it's less than 30 seconds. Here. Bringing Kuman again. He's managed to stop them, but he hasn't scored in either Archibaldi or Isaiah. He's got to go all out for it now. Kuman will leave him on. I just keep playing these two players against him. Ten seconds left. Can Kim get anything? A consolation point for himself, has missed anything. He's able to play his balling game. 4 seconds left. Azerbaijan. Take one of two champions for the second year winning. Azerbaijan take the World Taekwondo Team Championship. Repeat the result from last year. Azerbaijan take the team award for men. As they did last year, China take the team award for women. As they did last year.